Hello, everybody. My name is Allie Craig, and this is Empire Magazine's BS Brand Chronicles. Yeah, you know what that BS stands for. I have been doing branding for over 20 years, and I've kind of had enough. And so every single week with BS Brand Chronicles, I am going to, call out some of the branding techniques that entrepreneurs are being taught to do and tell you why they work, why they don't, and why, for most part, they're full of flippin' BS. On this week's episode, we're talking about the long sales page copy. So, you've all seen it. I don't even need to show you what it looks like. Thank God we're seeing less and less of it, but it still exists. Long sales page copy was brought about to say, here's one page, because if I ask someone to click, I could potentially lose them. One page of information that just scrolls and scrolls and scrolls on for forever. And the idea is that if you scrolled all the way at the bottom, you had bought in enough, even if you didn't read the copy, that you were like, damn it, I took all this time to scroll the bottom. I'm buying this product as long as it's not some crazy ridiculous price. I am going to buy it because you had invested all that time in simply scrolling on a web page. Well, that is the psychology behind it. Here's the problem when everyone uses psychology to the wrong point. Yes, technically, the more time you spend with a brand, the more you are technically invested in it. But that doesn't always mean the same thing. And when everyone uses the principle improperly, guess what? You end up with crazy things happening. So what does that look like for your brand? Well, what it looks like for your brand is people just get frustrated. They're getting frustrated, like, just tell me the damn price. I don't want to scroll anymore. Because if your client base and your audience base is very driven, like, let's get to the point, like, I want to make the deal, especially with high sales value, most of the time, the people who are going to say yes the fastest, they just want the details, the information, and forget the rest. So by forcing them to scroll, you force them to go down the same road as someone who's kind of, sort of, maybe possibly looking at the 500 payment plan versus the person who's going to pay you outright in the beginning. So do long sales page copy work? Not anymore, thank God, because the marketplace has been overrun. Just like how 99 cents is no longer 99, everything now is 97, and before that it was all 95. Those antiquated ideas, when we use psychology in a mass way improperly, we end up losing the effectiveness of the initial thought altogether. So long sales page copy doesn't work, especially like it used to. What does work is, number one, knowing your audience. If your audience comes to a sales page already primed, then you need to get to the nitty gritty of the details fast. And they really don't care about the logistics. They don't care if you're delivering it to them in 12 webinar series or 12 live calls or whatever it is. What they care is the outcome of, what do the live calls get them? What does the training videos get them? That's what you want to be selling. Sell that short, concise, and to the point. Guess what? Throw the number up there. That's what they want. And here's the thing. If your audience is coming to your sales page not primed, you don't have the right system in place. So if by chance you feel like they may accidentally find your sales page and they're not totally primed, then make sure that you have someplace clear and upfront that says, like, hey, not sure what this means, want more details, click here. And then you can bring them into an entire marketing series, which actually helps them understand your brand, understand the value, and understand the message at stake. That's important. So call BS when it comes to the power of a long sales page copy.